Chaya Sharma has been a police investigator in India for 14 years. She has seen a lot in her career, but nothing prepared her for the night of December 16, 2012.
That night, I had finished my patrolling around 12 o'clock and had retired home. So it was about 2:15 that my operator made a call and informed me. He did not have much details, but what I could understand was that something's happened to a girl and probably an heinous offense has occurred against her.
Moments after the young woman and her friend had boarded the bus, the five male passengers already on board dragged her to the back of the bus. Her friend was badly beaten. She was gang raped. The men took turns, even violating her with an iron rod, while the bus drove around the city for almost an hour. Then they were dumped by the side of the road, left for dead. By the time Sharma and a team of investigators reached the hospital, the young woman was already in surgery.
The atrocious, unbelievable injuries what she had sustained, we have never seen before. In my almost 40-year career, I have never witnessed such a horrific brutality by human beings.
Back home, her parents waited anxiously by the phone. When it finally rang, it was not their daughter at the other end.
We got a call from someone saying our daughter was injured and admitted in the hospital. We found out what had happened after we arrived at the hospital. We were shocked to see our daughter's state. What was in front of our eyes was hard to even imagine. We didn't know how to react for the first few moments.
When I first saw her, she was conscious and she was lying on the stretcher. She looked at me and started crying. I told her to keep calm and not to worry anymore, as I'd take care of everything. The doctors felt it was a miracle for her to be alive after such gruesome injuries. They informed us she might not be able to survive the surgery.
She told me they beat her badly. What could she say? Even I didn't have the courage to ask her anything. She was in great pain, so we never asked her anything. Even in so much pain, she would keep saying, "Don't worry, I'm doing better, and we'll get okay very soon."
Because she was young, she was healthy, and because of her willpower, that gave us hope that she might recover.
Beyond the hospital walls, Sharma and a team of investigators worked tirelessly with the clues given by the male victim. Time was not on their side.
The condition of the girl, as told to us, was such that I understood that it's going to be quite a serious case, and it's going to be, the repercussions can be quite bad. So I informed my team to be prepared for the challenge which lay ahead, and we should be ready with answers.
But Sharma says what they weren't prepared for was the reaction from across India and around the world. Within days, word of the brutal attack had spread. In a country where rape is often not reported and not prosecuted, the sheer brutality of the attack had struck a nerve. Demonstrators turned out by the thousands to say enough was enough. It was time to do more to protect women in India's capital.
It was because of huge public support that we were able to gather courage to put up a tough fight. We never thought something like this could ever happen to us, and in such a brutal manner. It shook the entire nation and led to public outrage on the streets. After seeing all that, we felt humanity still prevails on this earth.
Indian law prohibits naming a rape victim, so even though the public had never seen her face and didn't even know her name, she had become a symbol. In place of her real name, they began calling her Nirbhaya, the fearless one.